essential oil. Can you rub it into the palm of your hand? If you don't, that's fine. You're just going to still rub your hands together. So rub your hands together. And then bring your palms just in front of your face, a little further from your eyes. And take a deep breath in as you close your eyes and arrive with me. And just going to savor this essential oil breath. So deep breath in. And let it out. And do it again, feeling that aroma enter to the whole body. And exhale, let it out. And then do it one more time. And exhale. Slowly just start to rub your palms again. You might even place a little bit on your shoulders, on your body, just so you can feel that with you throughout your practice. Before we get started, we'll also just take a moment to look forward to your candle, if you have one. And just gaze forward to that flame that flickers in front of you. And if you don't have one today, perhaps you close your eyes and create that shape of the flame within. And as you gaze forward, just take some deep breaths arriving, just noticing what's evolving in this object right here. So notice any smoke that may rise from the tip of the flame. Notice the way that it moves. Notice the wax that pools at the bottom of it. And then notice the color. Now, of course, in Vinyasa Yoga, I brought a lot of reference to this golden flame breath that we hold right here. And so even in visualize that, that flame you look at right now is actually sitting in the pit of your belly. So it is your digestion, it is your organ health, it is your circulation, it is your hormones, it's right here, right? And then as you allow your back to lengthen and ground your hands, and you can keep your eyes focused on your flame, take a deep breath down towards the pit of that flame on the inhale. And on your exhale, gently start to collect up from the pelvic floor, squeeze the belly in and up, as if that fire is beginning to rise all the way to the tip point of your flame. And as you inhale, drop the breath down to pool the breath like the wax you see at the base. On the exhale, start to lift up from that pool, squeeze the pelvic floor, hug the belly in and up. And let that exhale start to rise, creating the tip of the flame at the top. On your inhale, soften the breath down. Pull that breath like the wax that lingers at the base. And on your exhale, begin to slowly pick it up from the root of the earth. Give a nice hug and lift across the lower belly and get to the tip of that flame. Inhale, breathe down. Soften as if to lighten and release the breath. And exhale, like that golden flame, begin to press up from the seat, pull up through the lower belly, and light that inner fire. On the inhale, soften as if there's an orb of light kind of melting and expanding in all directions. And on the exhale, start to pick it up, to light up that inner flame, to spark that energy, to spark that dedication and that intention, to simply showing up and taking control of your health. Inhale, soften, release down, create space, like that wax just lingering on the inhale. And on the exhale, begin to actively collect it and watch that flame start to reach and press up. Slowly inhale and soften. Take a moment just to sway the shoulders side to side. Today we practice our first well-being practice, which is called savoring. So when we get acquainted to the breath, to the movement, we're going to be completely absorbed right there. Savoring is the act of enjoying an experience and being mindful while you enjoy it, that you're enjoying it. So just notice here as you linger side to side that you're mindful of the way your body moves, what you enjoy about the experience of allowing your spine to wake up. And then shift forward with me, inhale, and circle back on the exhale. Do that a couple more times. Just slowly and gently finding your own rhythm. When you're ready, circle to the other side. So So remember that we will move more slow today with a focus on each pose and a focus on your breath, but slow can still be strong. One more time with that circle. And then gently find your center point. And just for a moment, place your right hand on your heart and your left hand on your belly. Close your eyes as you lengthen your back. Broaden your collarbone and take a deep breath down towards the pit of your pelvis. Inhale and soften. And as you exhale, pick it up from the root. Give a nice hug and lift. And let that set your intention for today. To be with each pose. To be with each breath. And if it's available for you to slide your candle a little further, but keep it as a focal point for you today. A reminder to stay with each breath, to stay with each pose. Take a deep full breath down, expanding that orb of light in all directions. And as you exhale, pick up that inner light, begin to press it and spread it up through your body all the way up and out. Inhale, soften. Breathe down to the root, feel your spine lift long. Exhale, collect from the earth, press up and allow that orb of light to expand and illuminate within. Gently lower your hands, plant them right by your side, sweep your right arm forward, inhale, reach to the left. And then slowly lean in to the left side. Spiral your gaze, feel your seat on the earth. Take a deep full breath down to your whole body. And as you exhale, enjoy that nice lift of the breath up and out. Lower your right hand down. Even notice that your fingertips touch the earth. Sweep your left arm forward. And then over to the right, lean back and exhale, lean into it. Spiral your heart to the left side. Feel that strong press of your right hand in support of your spinal lift. Take a deep full breath down on the inhale and exhale, gently press out and let that old air reach and rise. Gently begin to release down. And as you release down, let's begin to flow here. So inhale, sweep forward and exhale, just curl chin to heart. Inhale, circle forward and up. Exhale, dive into your center. Two more times. Inhale forward and exhale curl. And last time, inhale. And as you exhale, curl into your chest. Keep your lower back long. And take a deep full breath to the back of your body as if to illuminate the back body with some light and space. Exhale, press it out. Beautiful. Find your center point here. We're going to just flow a little bit. Slower, but we're still aware of what we're feeling here. So bring your feet together like a wide diamond in front of you. And as you inhale, reach forward, collect your palms. And on the exhale, bring your palms to your heart, press into your seat bones, and lift your spine up. Inhale, swim your arms forward. Exhale, wave back to your center and get long through your heart. Inhale forward, exhale, give a nice lift of pelvic floor to lower belly while you lift your spine. Inhale, forward. Now I have my candle in front of me, which can be a really nice focal point for you at the top of your mat. If it's safe, inhale, exhale, press up. Do that two more times, swimming forward for the whole duration of the inhale and lifting up for the full duration of the exhale. One more. And then plant your feet to the earth. Let long through your heart. And as you exhale, turn to the right and lean back. Keep your feet grounded. Inhale, center, come forward. Exhale, lean to the left, spiral, and exhale. Inhale, center, press your big toes together. Exhale to the right. Inhale, center, exhale to the left. And try to use your breath. Inhale, breathe down. Exhale, pick it up from pelvic floor to lower belly while you lean back to the right. Inhale, breathe down to the whole body. Exhale, swivel to the left. Notice there's no collapse of the lower back or the upper back like this. The heart is open on the twist. Inhale, center. Exhale, back. Good. Follow your breath. To each, it will be different pace. So yours may be slower,
or a little faster.
But notice that it's the full breath taking you on the exhale here, the inhale center, and the exhale back. And then find your center point. And as you do, collect your legs, unravel gently and slowly, even taking some time to feel the mat. Unravel gently and slowly onto an all fours position. So take your time to get there. And as you get there, see if you can really press your fingertips into the earth here. And for a moment, just look down at your palms, separate them nice and wide. And look at the grip that your fingertips make, like a gecko gripped on the wall. That fingertip action is the gecko gripped on the wall. Now gently beginning to flow here, we're gonna move together through a few poses. So you can keep your toes flat. Inhale, sink back. Child's pose. Exhale, start to swivel up. Lean forward into a low plank. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, take it back, child's pose. Follow the breath. Inhale here, breathe down. Exhale, collect from pelvic floor to lower belly. Lean into your low plank. Inhale, exhale, take it back. So there's a really strong connection to your breath here. Inhale, prepare. Exhale, lift up through pelvic floor, lower belly. Lean forward, inhale here. Exhale, take it back. One more. Inhale, prepare. Exhale, roll forward. Let your whole exhale carry you there. Inhale, fill. Exhale, send it back. Good. Do that one more time on your own. Inhale. Exhale, roll forward. Inhale here. And then take a couple breaths to lower all the way, keeping your core connection until you're flat on your belly. Now from here, let's try some cobra waves. Three to be exact. But again, following the rhythm of the breath. So here's your inhale. Exhale, collect from the pelvic floor, from the lower belly. Roll yourself in and up, shoulders on the back. Inhale here. Exhale, lower flat. So it's a four-part breath. Inhale, prepare. Exhale, chin into chest. Sweep up through your active exhale. Inhale at the top. Exhale, lower down. Remember that pelvic floor belly lift. Inhale, prepare. Exhale, circle into your heart. Inhale, lift and open. Exhale, lower halfway. Press your strong hands. Come back to your knees. Tuck your toes. And gently and slowly press back to your downward dog. Notice how your feet touch the earth and begin to gently just take a pulsation with your heels there. Noticing for a moment what parts of your body are being activated and coming back and centering into your breath as you inhale down and as you exhale to carve and lift through your out breath. Then take a very conscious step forward until you feel it's time to plant your heels, and that might mean your hands walk back and you're in the middle of your mat. Fold and bend your knees, release your brain, and just allow gravity to take hold of the weight of your body as you surrender to the security of the earth. Really present in how you press your feet down. Let them be your foundation. Inhale, breathe into the whole back body. Exhale, carve it up through pelvic floor, lower belly. Gently and slowly take 1 to 4 breaths to roll upward to stand. Take your time. Notice the active press of the feet and legs. As you come up, you can reach the arms over the head. Gently lean back, collect your finger pads, look up to your flame, and lower as you follow with your eyes, keeping that focus on your hands. Drop the weight of your shoulders. Inhale, breathe into the center of the space right here in your hands. Breathe down. Exhale, pick it up from the pelvic floor, hug the belly in and up. And gently lower the weight of the arms and let them swing free by your side. Come to the top of your mat so we can take a very basic core salutation. The top of your mat, notice how your feet touch down. Inhale, fly your arms up, lean lightly back but keep your core support. Exhale, bend your knees and fold over your long legs. Halfway lift, fingertips come to your shins and roll your spine into a halfway lift. Fingertips, gecko grip to the earth, slide down to knuckles and palms. Step back into downward dog. From your downward dog, notice the space between your feet. Shoulders that want to hang out up here, drop them down. Bend your knees, send your hips back, inhale. Come up onto your toes, lift your belly, and roll into plank on your exhale. Inhale, hold your plank, raise your gaze. Tap your knees, keep your belly lifted. A couple breaths to lower flat on the ground. Point your toenails, inhale, prepare. Exhale, chin to chest. Circle yourself in and up, pubic bone stays down. Inhale up here. Exhale, lower halfway. Press your strong hands, lift your belly either here or pointed plank and carry your way back to downward dog. Take a deep full breath into your whole body and maybe sigh it out through your mouth like this. Inhale, bend the limbs. Raise the right leg up. Keep your left knee bent. Exhale, curl your right knee to your heart. Press away. Step your right foot to your hand. Lengthen your spine. Raise your gaze and pulse one breath here. Inhale, breathe down. Exhale, press up from pelvic floor to lower belly. Ground your gecko grip and step back with your right leg all the way into the sky. Keep your left knee bent. Bend your right knee. Open your right hip and your shoulders are going to want to turn. Square them down, lift the belly, and breathe. Lower your right foot to the floor. Walk it out and feel your breath. Stay there. Breathe in your downward dog. When you're ready, bend your limbs, raise your left leg up, inhale. Use your exhale to carry forward into your core plank. Step your left foot forward to your hand. Lengthen your spine, bending into your left leg. Breathe down on the inhale, looking forward. Scoop it up from the pelvic floor to lower belly on your exhale. Plant your strong hands down. Actually, we're gonna bend the back knee. Inhale, prepare, exhale, spring forward. Top of the mat. Lengthen up halfway, fingertips to the floor or the shins. Exhale, fold. And then hang out with some heavy arms. Press the weight firmly into the right leg and start to roll up with your left leg. Hands to the hips. As you come up here with your left leg, you're like this. You just take some circles with me. Inhale, exhale. So again, stay really focused on the breath here. If you're comfortable to take your flame, you can do that. Or just place your hands back at your hips. Inhale. Exhale. Now fold as you bend all the way down. Lengthen up halfway, grow. Plant the weight into your left foot. Keep your hips back. Strong press of your left foot. Start to peel your right leg up. Hands to the hips. Open out here, inhale, and exhale. Just take some time, it doesn't have to look pretty, it has to feel strong. Notice for you how far that inhale carries you until the exhale takes over. One more, plant your foot down, sweep up, inhale, open your heart, collect your finger pads, and exhale, follow as you lower with your gaze point to your hands. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, let it out. One more, inhale, breathe down. Exhale, press up, light your flame. gently release and come back to the top of your mat. We'll move into another variation. Again, keeping that element of savoring and breath and movement active. Connected to the earth, feel your feet plant on the floor. Inhale, sweep up. Gently lean back, keep your core support. Exhale, bend your knees and fold over your legs. Fingertips to the floor or the shins, roll up halfway, get long through the back body. Take some time to grip the mat, plant into it, and step back into downward dog. From your downward dog, notice the weight of your shoulders to drop back. Knees can be bent, heels do not have to touch the floor. Be with your natural element. Inhale, bend everything back. Use your exhale to lift onto your tippy toes. Carry up through the left exhale all the way into plank. Contain at the core. Press away from the earth. Tap the knees. Lean the heart forward. Keep that belly connected to the spine. And gently lower. Plant your hands, look down. And then swivel up on your next inhale. Lower halfway. Press your hands, come back to your knees or tuck your toes. Pointed plank is an option. Carry yourself back into downward dog. So once you're here in your downward dog, inhale, bend the limbs, raise the left leg up. Bend and open your hip. Shoulders want to skew, so bring them back to center. Take one circle with me there, open up. Turn your shoulders down, breathe, and feel that nice firm press of your fingertips down to the earth. Lengthen and release. Good. Inhale, bend everything, raise your right leg to the sky, left knee stays bent. Exhale, carry your right knee in, press away, step your right foot to your right hand. Stay there for a moment, just feeling the press of your feet to the earth as I spin around. And prepare for a lunge. Can be a low one if it suits you today. Otherwise, it's a high one. Raise your back knee, bend it, lengthen your spine. Bend your back knee, use your exhale to roll forward, collecting from the belly inward and outward. Take a moment to stabilize in your lunge here and free your arms. Nice. Then as you inhale, sweep up into your lunge. Open up gently through the back body and through the front body. Inhale, exhale, slowly sink. Inhale, press back through your back leg. Inhale, gently bend it. Good. Pulse your inhale and your exhale, even if it doesn't match my cue. Pulse it. And then lower the fingertips. Feel them touch down. Open your left foot to the long edge of your mat. Walk inside and gently just stay here. So now your left foot faces the long edge of your mat. Your right foot faces the short edge. Breathe. Bend into your front knee, collect up through center, lengthen everything, reach up through your flame, and as you exhale, press away. As you bend into your front knee, find your warrior two. Then look to your back hand for a moment. Keep your eyes focused on that, feeling the bend into your front knee, the breath into your body. Good, inhale. Exhale, pulse up from pelvic floor to lower belly. Turn your palms away. Bring your knuckles to your low back. Interlace your hands. Lift and open your back. Breathe in. And as you exhale, circle forward towards your inner right side. Inhale, circle up. The next time you come down, you hold. Option to keep the arms out. Press your strong feet down. Notice the weight of both legs is even and breathe into your whole body for your bound arm warrior. And then slowly start to lean out of it. Take your back left hand to your left thigh. Swivel your right arm down. Reach it up over the head for humble warrior. Lean gently back, but maintain a lift of your spine. Spiral your gaze up. Keep the bend through your front knee. Even if it is a little fire beginning to awaken in the leg, savor that sensation that represents your strength. Inhale and exhale. Go ahead and turn both feet forward and take some time to be here in a wide-legged stance. Reach the arms wide. Then as you exhale, start to float your way down over your bent knees. Fingertips come to the floor here. Inhale, lengthen. Bend your knees lightly, keep your hips back, and fold over your long legs, descending through your head. If you're comfortable, you can lunge side to side, awakening a feeling in your inner thighs, or you can stay in stillness and center back into your breath, your choice. Let it be a bit more slow than you usually go. Nice strong press of your feet. Lengthen up halfway, grow. Bend your knees, take your hips back, and roll yourself inward and upward. Nice. Find your standing pose. Turn your left foot towards the front of your mat. Take your hands down, lift your back leg up and turn it forward. Press into your strong hands and step back into downward dog. Take a deep breath here, feeling your fingertips fire up. And for a moment, just notice that nice full inhale drop down. And that nice strong active exhale pulse up from pelvic floor to lower belly. So you're taking a moment to savor and notice that one cycle of breath. Then inhale, bend, send everything back. Raise your left legs up. And as you exhale, curl your left knee to your heart. Step your left foot to your hand. Turn your right foot and we'll stay here for a lunge. So you can either come down or you can keep it up. Lengthen your spine, bend your back knee, and use your exhale to roll up off the earth. And then sweep along through your back leg. Just hang out here with your hands on your thighs or by your side for a moment. As you inhale, open out. Nice. You can look forward to one point or gently up. And then inhale, back off. And exhale, just dive your back knee down. Inhale, press it back. Exhale, lower. Follow the breath. Inhale. Exhale. Lower your hands. Frame your left foot. Turn your right foot to the long edge of your mat. Walk your hands inside. Keep your left toes facing forward. Bend both knees to free your pelvis. Bend into your front knee, keep your hips back. Next exhale, collect from the earth. Reach everything up, maybe connect your flame. Exhale, press away and find your warrior two. Find your warrior two, maybe look back, relax your shoulders, and awaken your breath, which is going to be your inhale down and your exhale up from the pelvic floor to the lower belly. Inhale, soften the breath down, feel that candle wax melting and widening. And on your exhale, pick it up from the root, give a nice lift so your flame lights up. Gently start to release, right hand to back leg. Circle your left arm down, peel it up over your head. Instead of just kind of hanging out in this hip, sweep your spine in and up. And gaze up while you maintain action into your front thigh, bending through your front knee. One more deep breath down on your inhale, and exhale, pick it up. Now I'm not used to moving this slow, like this is slower for my style of yoga, but it kind of aligns with this whole practice that we're working on this week. Find your way down to the floor. Turn your left foot forward. Let it align with your right foot. And then we're going to turn our heels in. Keep your hips back, toes open, inner thighs wide, seat back. Roll yourself in and up. So slow, of course, is still strong and an active practice. But when you're not used to it, it makes you lean into a different space. Gently and slowly, just as I'm doing, begin to sway and ripple through your spine. Nice. So we're just going to take some pulses here. Maybe starting to feel your legs a little bit warm now, right? So you're going to come come up as you inhale, collect. And on the exhale, sink back down, inner thighs wide, spine tall. Inhale, and then exhale, lower. Now we're gonna change the breath cycle to align to our belly button fire breath. So as you inhale, you wanna drop down. And on your exhale, pick it up from the root and light that flame. Inhale, breathe down, sink, warm and widen. Exhale, collect from the pelvic floor, lower belly, and pulse up. One more. Exhale. And then sink back to your goddess. Find the floor. You may be a little wavy, gravy as you get there. Turn everything to the front of the mat. Take your time to get there. And step back to downward dog. Beautiful. Take a deep breath here. Exhale, lower the knees. Knees can be wide or close. Block is there if you have. Find your child's pose with your forehead on the block. Rest your arms back there by your side. Take a deep full breath down on your inhale. Releasing the breath to the back of your body. Warming and widening at the low back. Exhale, give a nice lift of pelvic floor to lower belly. Feeling a warmth and heat within.
Different, or you spark up some heat within.
pulse your belly bonfire, exhale and inhale. I love that. I know so many of you on this group because I know you know that breath now. You'll start to walk back. Back off, raise your leg up and spring forward. Come to the middle of your mat if it feels good. Lengthen up halfway. Exhale, fold. I'll spin around, but you stay where you are. We're going to bring your weight into the right leg and keep your block handy if you need for your hand there. And pick up your left leg. Bend your right knee a lot. That is so important for your pelvis and lower back. And just begin to circle now. Inhale, center. Exhale, open. Inhale, center. Exhale, open. Now the next time you come to center, take some time to lift the belly, lengthen the spine, and continue with the circles. Maybe add the arm or simply place it at the hip, moving at your own level. Exhale. Nice. You can even come back down here if it feels more comfortable. And if you're going to go for your full expression, you may lift up, lengthen, reach. Up on those right fingertips, and then slowly release. Draw it back down to center, curl up halfway, exhale, fold, come up to stand, inhale, open through your heart, fingertips, and let that exhale carry you down to the earth. By stretching it out, right foot forward, left leg back, take your right foot to the edge of your mat there. Bend your right knee over your ankle, lower down through your left leg. You might even peel your right foot open like a book, and then start to walk over to the corner left side of the mat. Back your hips off. Trickle your spine and arms longer, but maintaining that backed off hip area. Deep breath down on your inhale. Exhale, pick it up from the root. Squeeze the belly in and up. Savor what you feel, so be mindful of the experience that you're having. There's no other moment but now. And then gently and slowly find your way back. And you can take yourself back into one last downward dog if that feels good. It might. Before you come to tap your knees to the earth and press your way back up to sit. Okay, as we stay seated now, that one kind of crept up on you, right? So you're gonna go ahead and come into a twisted portion. Keep your left leg curled in. Step your right foot over. If this is way too bendy for you, then go ahead and unravel your left leg forward. Your seat bone should touch the earth. Lengthen up your spine. As you inhale, reach up. We're going to do this twist a little different today, so I'm actually going to spin to the side. See me. Good. Inhale, reach up. Collect your palms or your flame fingertips. Exhale, turn to the right. And then maybe your arm just settles here. Sweep up through your spine, inhale. And you're going to stay here the whole time, pressing your arm into your leg as if to resist it. Drop the shoulders as much as you can. Deep breath down on the inhale, soften to the pelvic floor. A nice active pull up of that orb of light on the exhale. Relax the shoulders, close the eyes if it serves you. Raise your fingertips here if it really feels better to just release one hand back. Keep the other one like a sword, nice and strong. But stay at center here. Breathe down on the inhale. And exhale, carve it up. From the pit of your core, your pelvic floor. Slowly release. So we're just gonna go ahead and drop this leg down a little bit. It's not really any particular pose right now, but we're gonna still stretch the side. So it doesn't have to be perfect. Your legs can look as they are for your bones. And inhale, reach up. Move down on the exhale and move to the left side. Until you feel a stretch across the side of your leg. Your spine nice and long and press your knee bones into the earth. Take a full deep breath here. Fill up your whole back body.
a nice active exhale, press it out. Nice, do that one more time. And then you need to work your way center, right hand down, left hand up, reach to the right. Deep full breath here. And then release. Stretch your legs out for a moment. Circle your ankles, nice tall back. And then we'll switch sides. So you can tuck your right leg underneath and then take your left leg over. Seat bones are nice and active to the earth. You're really dropping through that right hip here. Sweep your spine long, inhale, fly. Flame fingertips or palms together to Anjali Mudra and then turn over to the left. Take your right arm and just kind of hook it there. Inhale, sweep your spine nice and long, especially through your low back. And then exhale, just turn sideways. You're not even really looking back today. You are just looking to the sides, something different. It's primarily to get you to work more and avoiding any twist in the low back. And then backing off to savor what this offers for you today. Deep breath down on the inhale. Nice active pulsation, pelvic floor to lower belly lift on the exhale. So that is your orb of light expanding in all directions through your exhale, helping to light you up. One more. Keep your neck nice and long. And then gently release. Now this arm, this leg's just gonna kind of relax and be as it is. Inhale, reach up. Start to walk your way down. Inhale, back off. And then you can go ahead and just walk to the corner right side, away from your left top hip. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold, but maintain the press of your seat bones and a long back. So if I'm going to round here, compromising the back, I'm going to sweep up nice and long. Just be mindful of where your body is right now and be present with that. Take a deep breath down on the inhale. Nice active pulsation out through the exhale, feeling the drop of the left hip. You're gonna back it off, come up, and then plant your right hand down. You can lean over to the left there, lean over to the right. Deep breath, and exhale. Find your legs straighter. Of course, your knees can still be bent. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, wave down. Brush your fingertips on the mat. Inhale, up. Exhale, dive down. Feel the mat. Inhale, wave up. And then exhale, wide fingertips. Lengthen your spine and play the edge of stretch. Maybe sliding your heels slightly forward. Inhale, lengthen, exhale, bow and fold till you feel your first stretch. Sweep your spine nice and in and up. Breathe down on your inhale. And a nice active exhale to hug up from the root, release your brain.
Instead of just like yanking and pulling the leg in,
Keep the hip down and find a good resistance where you feel your first stretch. Maybe keep a gaze point forward, up to the ceiling, whatever it is for you. And then slowly release. Take your block, you know my favorite block work here. Bend your knees, press into your feet, sweep your spine up. Block underneath your sacrum, above your low back, beneath your low back, above your bottom. Got it. Rest your arms down, palms can face into the earth. And then if you're comfortable, hug your knees up. Using the block or cushion or even just the floor, raise your legs to the sky. Inhale, breathe. Exhale, empty it all out. Relax the weight of your shoulders, the weight of your mind, the weight of your heart. Because right now is the only moment that exists. So choose to be there. Option to open up the legs. I'm going to hit my wall again. You let your legs just surrender to gravity. Deep breath. In and out. The weight of your legs drop away from center. So that gravity comes up to hold you and you surrender to the pull. Gently swivel back to center. Plant your feet down. Widen your feet to the edges of your mat. Knock your knees together. Breathe to your whole front body right here. Exhale, let it out. Inhale, breathe, expand. Exhale, release. No more belly bonfire breath, just a nice active inhale and a softening exhale. And when you're ready, lift up off your block, plant it to the side, and take some time to spread out into the earth now. We're going to take a nice relaxation today that we can also savor fully. So rest down onto your back, palms face up. Take a deep full breath in on the inhale. And a nice full active exhale up and out. Continue to stay on the earth, just enjoying the surface of the earth beneath you. Begin to close your eyes. You're going to stay seated. I'm going to come up to sit. You're going to stay laying down. Rest your back body down on the earth. Even feel the warmth of the surface beneath you. Your shoulders melt back. Feel your arm bones sink down all the way to your palms. So I'd like to practice a technique of tighten and release for our relaxation today. So let's begin by bringing attention to our face. Try to scrunch your face up real tight. And then release it as you breathe out. Relax your eyes, your cheekbones, your jaw, your tongue, your jawline, skin across your hairline, your ears, everything softening. Then try to tighten up around your neck and shoulders. Inhale and exhale, relax your neck and shoulders. Let them drop down. Tighten your fists into a real tight squeeze. Inhale and exhale. Open them and let your fingertips soften and naturally unravel. To
tighten up through your belly and chest, holding everything in. And the next exhale, let it out. Soften your belly, soften your chest. Release the side of your body. Tighten up through your bottom, squeezing it in. And the next exhale, soften, release the muscles of your bottom all the way out. Tighten up through the top of your legs and squeeze them. Then as you exhale, soften your legs, release, and let the weight of them drop into the earth. Finally, tighten up across your toes and your feet. And as you exhale, soften, release the weight with your feet. Allow your toes to gently relax and unravel. Choose to stay here, enjoying a sense of release, breathing in and out to a natural rhythm, an organic breath. Up through your breath and a full breath out. Move your fingertips, move your toes, you move your wrists and your ankles. Hug your center, embrace yourself for showing up. Rock side to side until you can roll over to the right side and stay there for a moment. Then start to build your way back up to sit. Still have your candle within your gaze. Take a moment to connect back to it. If you don't, close your eyes and visualize your flame. Visualize the pool of wax that has gathered, representing all that you choose to let be. Visualize the lift of that flame to spark your intention that will carry you forth for the rest of the week until we meet again. Let that inner flame represent that intention. Take a deep full breath in, a deep full breath out, observing your flame. Place your right hand over your heart, your left hand over your belly. Inhale, fill up. Exhale, empty. And bow to your center for showing up today.